Good morning, Calvary, and welcome to your word for the day. My name is Pastor Mitch, and today we're going to be looking at Genesis chapter 49. See, this chapter covers the end of Jacob's life, and we're told that Jacob knows that he is near death, and we read about the various blessings that Jacob speaks over his sons. See, some of these blessings are very positive, while others were not. And when I saw what passage today that we were covering, I was wondering what it was that God was speaking to me through this passage, because at first glance, it didn't jump right out at me. And then I began to think about this as if I was in Jacob's shoes. If I were him, what am I thinking about at the end of my life? And I realized that these blessings that he speaks over his sons are a reflection of Jacob's own legacy. And when Jacob told his son Dan that he will provide justice for his people, I'm sure that he said it with pride in his voice. But when he told Simeon and Levi that their anger is cursed and their fury is cruel, he was taking an honest look at the types of sons he had raised and the truth of what his legacy entailed. My favorite part was after he seemed to praise Dan, he then goes on to say that Dan will be a snake by the roadside, a viper along the path that bites the horse's heels so that its riders tumble backwards. And then in verse 18, he adds that favorite part, which reminded me of some of our junior high parents, when he adds, "I look for your deliverance, Lord." See, we each have a legacy. We're all going to leave something behind, whether it is in the impact that we had on our own kids, our friends, or our neighbor down the street. We all have a legacy that we all get to take, and we all get to take ownership in that legacy. See, we're never going to be perfect on this side of heaven. We're never going to be able to avoid making mistakes, but it is in how that we respond to those mistakes. It is in how we respond to the tough moments of our life that define our legacy. So my question for you is, if you were to die today, what would your legacy be? Is there anything that you would change? Now remember that you are still breathing. God still has a plan for you, and if you are happy with the direction your life is headed in, then be encouraged to continue down that path and don't give in to temptations. But if you're not happy with the legacy that you would leave behind, then take a step today in changing what your legacy looks like. See, God loves you and he wants the best for you. And I will leave you with this verse, Proverbs 3, 5 through 6. It says, "Trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not on your own understanding. All your ways acknowledge him and he will make your paths straight." Thank you for tuning into your word for the day. Like and share this video, and we will see you tomorrow.